Hey everybody, I have a little bit of an Amazon fashion haul for you. So I've been accumulating a bunch of stuff and it's time to run through it. If you've been following me on Instagram, you've seen quite a few of these pieces already, but this is the first time I'm debuting them in a try-on, so to speak, here on YouTube. So sizes and prices, as of at least the day I'm filming, will be going across the screen and in the description box as well. So be sure to hit show more. I will list everything in the description box in the order in which you're seeing it here on the video. So if you have any questions, be sure to check the screen and the description box first. And then, of course, if you still have more questions, feel free to comment and I will do my best to answer. So, number one, starting with this camo hoodie, which is a complete Amazon mistake that I think turned out into something good. What I had intended on ordering, and the order I actually placed, was for a pink camo or like a gray, green, pink camo sweatshirt. And that's what it says on the order form. But what they sent me was this camo hoodie, which is like not even remotely, like it's not the same color, same style, whatever. It turns out I absolutely love this hoodie. Normally, I would not be wearing it with jeans and booties. But in the interest of time, I'm wearing it this way. I find that there's a little bit of a hole in my athleisure wear, and I don't have sort of like a lightweight hoodie that I can throw on over a t-shirt or a tank or whatever in my workout gear. Not, we're just gonna leave it at that. So I actually am going to keep this. I'm not gonna send it back. I still am going to order the sweatshirt that I intended on ordering. I'll put a picture of it on the screen here so you can see what I was going for. I've seen it on other Instagrammers and bloggers. I think it's super cute and it had great reviews. So I still want to get it, but I really, really like this hoodie. So if you're looking for a lightweight, it's almost like a dry fit material, I highly recommend it. It's super comfortable and soft and a great transitional piece for moving into spring. Number two, I found on the new releases list on Amazon, and I am looking for camis that you can layer under cardigans and stuff, but something that I can wear my normal bra. I mean, I have some great strapless bra options and I'll list those below, and I have the nippies that I love. Yes, that's what they're called, those stick-on things. They're fabulous, but sometimes a girl just wants to wear a normal bra. And I love these camis because you can absolutely do that. They're really more of a tank top. They have the silky, satiny feel of a camisole, but they have the wider straps. They have really pretty lace detail. There are other colors. There's a beautiful sort of robin's egg blue I have my eye on. It's a nice length. You can wear it with leggings. It covers all of the pertinent things that you would want covered, but it tucks in nicely as well. I did have to steam this. It came with some creases in it, but it steamed very nicely. I'm very pleased with it. The armholes are, I'd say, of average depth. The bra I'm wearing in this video, I probably would not normally wear. I have a couple bras where they dip a little lower on the sides, and that's probably what I would choose to wear with this one, but I don't think you need to do anything special as far as a bra to wear with these tank camisole kind of combo options. I'm really pleased with this option as well. And then I paired it just for the purposes of this try-on with this gorgeous blue cardigan, the sort of heavier knit cardigan, chunky, not heavy, but chunky knit cardigan. You've seen this on Instagram. I think I wore this. I can't remember if I wore this in a video already or not, but I absolutely love this cardigan. I could not be more pleased. Comes in a variety of colors. I like this pretty blue. It's a bright, happy blue. It's perfect for this time of year. It's very dreary, as I think you can tell. It's really gray around me right now. I'm just filming with a natural light, and it's just soft right out of the, I want to say box, but I think it came in like a in an envelope type thing, and didn't smell weird or anything. And it has functional pockets. It doesn't button. It's an open kind of hanging type cardigan, but absolutely comfy and easily layered over a whole variety of things. I love this next top. This white thermal, it's sort of a spin on your typical sort of Henley thermal concept. I like the, I guess it's more of a notched collar. Sizing I found ran very true to size. I'm wearing it in a small. If you want a more oversized, definitely size up. Again, it comes in other color options. I have washed this several times. It washes well. I threw mine in the dryer. Oftentimes with Amazon clothes, I'm a little iffy as to whether or not I want to throw things in the dryer, but this did not shrink. Came right out of the dryer, didn't need to iron it. It's very soft. There's no stiffness to it. It draped very nicely, and I should have led with this, but I will put my personal sizing information in the description box. People have asked me in prior videos, so I'll just reiterate, I put the sizing in there not to brag, like, here's my height and weight and measurements and look at me. It's, if you're anything like me, I read Amazon reviews or, you know, any website reviews when I'm trying to figure out what size I am. I read the reviews to see if people reference their height and weight and bra size so that I can figure out if it worked for them that size, then that's the size I should probably order. So that's why I'm listing my height, weight, bra size. Moving forward, I found that this ran true to size and absolutely love it. And it's a great layering piece, but I like wearing it all by itself as well. Next, we have a personal favorite, the Red Star sweater. It's really oversized. This is in fact a small, I promise. It does come in black and I believe a tan. There are a variety of sellers on Amazon that sell this. It sells out all the time. I love it in the red, just the bright red, happy, it's another happy color. I don't know why I keep saying that, but it just makes me smile when I wear it. You can wear it with leggings. That's what I have done in the past. I've also worn it and I'm wearing it in the try-on with jeans. You can tuck it in. It's thin enough that you can do that. You can do a full tuck. You can do the half tuck. And it's just, it's fun. I like it. I love the stars. It's very untrend and it's not a major price commitment. So if it goes out of style next season, it's not a big deal, but I love it. And again, I wash it in my washing machine on the Delicate Cycle and I do have it dry flat. That one is not going in the dryer. Ah, the Be Kind tee. I think everybody needs this t-shirt, or at least needs to take in the message. I recently wore this on our trip to Savannah and layered it just under a jacket, but in this case, I rolled the sleeves up just a little bit. And I want you to note that I just washed it because we just got back. And pull this right out of the dryer. And I didn't need to iron it or anything. It just came out perfect the way it is. So that's a plus. And again, I'm pretty sure I ordered this true to size. Didn't size up on this one. And it does come in at least one other color option that I'm aware of. And there are a ton of, again, sellers on Amazon that have some form of this graphic, this Be Kind concept. I think it is a wonderful sentiment that we should all take to heart, especially on the internet. Here in San Antonio, there's been some recent sadness and bullying, and so it especially hits home here where I live, but I think it's just a great t-shirt that everyone maybe should consider wearing. Anyway, moving on to the next one. I've had this for a while, a couple months anyway. This one I love, but I want to warn you a little bit. So this is the black dolman sleeve, sort of thermal. And I saw this, I think, on the bestseller section on the Amazon website. And I was immediately drawn to it because it looked like this really cool, oversized top that you could wear with leggings or skinny jeans. And part of the appeal was the oversized bit of it with the more fitted sleeve. So, and it insisted, all the reviews said order true to size. So I did. And as you can see, it fits pretty well, but it's not quite as oversized on me as I would have liked. I think I'm a little chestier maybe than the average person. That's on me. But if you want more of that oversized look that you see on the website, I would advise sizing up. I haven't found that it has shrunk or anything in washing, but it wasn't nearly as big. And the arms do run a little more snug. They're not overly tight, and I don't have skinny arms. They're fine, but if you want that oversized feel, go up a size. Next, we have this beautiful embroidered blouse. I think it looks far more expensive and feels far more expensive than it actually is. And with most of the clothing options that you'll find on Amazon, there are probably a dozen options when you click on it. There's different color combinations, different sleeve lengths, different embroidery options. So this is one of easily a dozen. I chose for a slightly, I think this is a 3/4 length sleeve. There are short sleeve options, there are longer sleeve and so forth. I like a navy. I think it's a very neutral color. I wore this on our trip to Savannah. I wore it tucked in a pair of jeans. You could wear this with a variety of options. You could dress it up with a nice pair of slacks, a skirt, white jeans. I see this in the summer, getting it in more of the short sleeve option. So many other great color options. If the navy one that I chose isn't your thing, definitely check it out. And I honestly can't remember what size I ordered, so it'll be on the screen, but very pleased. I've washed this as well, and it washed it. I also did not throw in the dryer. Washed in the washing machine on gentle, and dry flat. Now moving on out of tops into a skirt. I seem to polarize the audience here with my choice of pleated midi skirts. It's not for everyone, but if you like a pleated midi skirt, they're very on trend right now. This particular manufacturer does offer them in solids as well. I love the paper bag waist, which is very on trend for this season as well. And it has pockets and the price point is amazing. I do find it runs true to size. The elastic waist is super forgiving. It can really give quite a bit more. When I first pulled it out of the packaging, I thought there is no way this is gonna fit. It looked super tiny. But once I put it on, I realized there was a lot of room. I actually first tried it on wearing a sweater and I could tuck in the sweater and there was still room. So there's a lot of room in there. I just decided to pair it with a denim kind of chambray top, kind of go with the rodeo theme. It's just an old, really comfortable top and some sort of Western influence boots. I don't know if you can see those in the shot or not, but those are old out of my closet. But I love the skirt. It's actually finished really well, I think, and the price point is fabulous. But again, if that pattern is not your thing, they have a bunch of solids as well. Okay, this is probably completely inappropriate, but I'm calling this my funeral dress because it's black. But like I mentioned, it does come in, oh gosh, I don't know how many other options. There are quite a few other solid color options. It's a beautiful dress. I feel it run true to size and it's very forgiving because I am not wearing Spanx in this shot. And if I were to wear this out of the house, I would definitely wear Spanx. I would feel a lot more comfortable if I had Spanx underneath because this is very fitted, but the material is really stretchy. So while it's fitted, it gives you room to kind of move about. It's not binding and uncomfortable. I love the way the collar has the notch. I love this, the sort of, I don't know what you call those sleeves, the little flare on the sleeves. It's a really pretty silhouette. I think it's really figure flattering. It makes your waist look really tiny and everything else look very Hollywood-esque. I think it's beautiful. I love everything about it. I feel like it looks far more expensive than it really is and probably wouldn't necessarily wear it to a funeral. I mean, I'm joking, but I think this would be beautiful for a more conservative office setting. You could put a blazer over this, a cardigan. I mean, it's just a really versatile piece, and I think it's definitely something that looks good and should be in most grown women's closets, a dress of this sort of silhouette, and I don't know where I'm going with this. I was shocked. This is not the kind of dress I normally go for by any means, and I didn't think I was going to like it and just sort of went for it, and I'm really happy with it. So glad that I went out on a limb and ordered this dress. And then the last piece that I picked up, I know many of you are probably not going to like, but I like it, and that's kind of the point. And I will explain the reasons why I like this. It's what I'm wearing right now. It's very boho, it's very flowy, and I did get it in a medium because the small was on back order and I just wanted it. And I probably could have sized down for the small. The reason why I love it, first of all, if you've watched me for a little bit, you know I like flowy printed dresses, and that's what I like, so that's what I'm gonna wear. But also, come 2 or 3 months from now, when we start hitting mid 90 degree weather, when I come into the house and I'm just sweaty and I don't want anything touching me, these are the kind of dresses I wanna wear around the house. So this is sort of my version of a house dress, and the price point is just perfect. And when I'm hanging around the house, I won't be wearing a belt, I'll just let everything sort of flow, and you know, I'm dressed, but I don't have anything binding on and sticky. This would make a great swimsuit cover up. It's better than just lounging around in a nightgown. Okay. So, or running, I could run to the grocery store. I'm dressed, but I don't feel like I remember very distinctly what it feels like to be very hot and uncomfortable. Those months are not far away. So these kind of flowy, easy to wear dresses, you throw on a pair of sandals and run out the door. They're nice to have when you live somewhere where it gets extremely hot. They do have these dresses in more of a short sleeve option, which obviously would be a better choice. But strangely enough, when you come in from the heat and you come into air conditioning, it's a weird dichotomy where you're super hot, but then the air conditioning makes you also feel a little chilled. So I like dresses like this. They're very on trend. And there are about a dozen print and color options from this manufacturer. And if you like this concept, they have them short sleeve, they have different necklines and so forth. So if you like this concept, click on, when you go to the website, click on the name of the brand and it'll take you to all the different clothing options that they make. And then the belt is, actually this is the second version of this belt. I have one of these in a larger size so I can wear it more like closer to my hips. But I ordered it a size down, and I probably should have gone even two sizes down to wear it closer to my true waist. And it's the kind of belt where you can, it has like a little prong here, and you just kind of put it in the hole, and it's really easy to wear. And just, you know, a fun take on more the designer belt for a far lower price. So those were my pieces for my most recent Amazon haul. I've been collecting them over the last couple of months or so. This wasn't all at once, but the way these things are priced, it's not a huge commitment, and they're fun pieces to wear now and later. Some of these are great closet staples, and some of them are very much trendy and will probably not make it to another season. But if you're interested, like I said, everything is listed down below. I also have an Amazon store, that's what they call it, where I have put all of the pieces that I have picked up, whether they're clothing items, stuff from my kitchen, whatever, in one place. So if you're ever curious to see what it is that I'm ordering for our house in general, all those are listed under my Amazon store, which is in the description box. As always, I appreciate you taking time out of your day to hang out with me, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.